It has been 2 years since I came into possession of the private logs, long ago secreted from the man who called himself Hunter Rose.
No! And here we are, in the twilight of our own making. I must share some of my secrets with you now, Arjun. And I mean my real secrets. The mysteries of power, of daring domination, and the easily ruptured will of the common man. If I share these with you now, will you promise not to use them against me? Don't bother to answer. I know, of course, that you would, if you could. Those days are gone. Let me tell you about the true power. Since the whirlwind years that have carried me from a Midwestern hell, I have come to realize that there are many vessels for capacity and talent. Life is so frivolous in its random deposits of potency. But it is the will that matters, not the muscle. Take yourself, for example. A frightful capacity. However, you are a marvel of might. In the several hundred years of your existence, I can easily assume you've killed far more than me. Or maybe the numbers are exactly the same. That's always been the problem. You bewail your astonishing faculties and form as a curse. A yoke placed around your neck by that same ethereal unknown that outfits us all. And that is what distinguishes us both. You growl with remorse while I laugh.
We are nothing alike.
Yes, well, when I came to accept the reality of myself, I became forever free of the trappings of outcome. I have everything the world can offer, and fear nothing for losing it. You have nothing but your own pain. Fear the loss of even that. Life rewards only those who want it to. And that is the true secret of power, found only in the capacity and marriage of desire and capacity. The thus empowered find themselves divorced of such pitiful notions as morality or faith. My power was absolute because I wanted it so. What the world couldn't or wouldn't give me, I took. What challenges it failed to provide me, I devised. What thrills it denied me, I conceived. I wanted this world far more than it ever wanted me. Everything is my own fault, and I love it so, all because I wanted it.
You are an abomination.
Don't you understand? True power is hammered into perfection. Its mighty clash, cold, crisp, and clear, like the ringing report of steel against steel. I am that swinging blade, and you are my anvil.
I don't think so.
Because of desire, there was Grendel. Because of myself, he was majestic. Because of you, trying ever to stop me, I was unstoppable.
No, you chose this.
Now I see. It was all because of Stacy that I lost my foothold on the ladder of dominion and fell. I should never have done it. I should never have taken her from you.
You?
I knew the Reynolds sham would have a disastrous effect. Stacy is a headstrong child. Not easily swayed when she's formed an opinion. I knew your public humiliation would soon sow seeds of revulsion in her tender mind. What I failed to realize was that soon everything began to repulse her. I admit, I was driven by our endless deadly dance. At that point, I hadn't realized its necessity. I was simply frustrated by your incessant challenge. And I suppose I was always jealous of her affection for you. It was so selfless, and yet so unsolicited. I knew that. But I also felt sure that you were never much concerned for her welfare. Only her endearments.
I care for her.
Of course I know that now. Isn't it obvious? I wonder how long she has known that I am Grendel. And how she found out. It doesn't matter now. She is special. And that's enough.
It has been her tonight. Oh, cross. It's a cross. She is prodding us.
Positioning us. She has learned her lessons far better than I dared think. And here, it was only just you again. I should have known I should have been things from her. She was my legacy, and my love, and my... So you see, stars do indeed fall from the heavens, don't they? Then, the hammer falls, and the spark is struck. The mightier the blow, the more ferocious the flashing gleam. And thereafter, alas, they are only destined to fall. There, I have said the hated word.
Oh, it's desperate.
They tumbled to earth with the rest of the mud. Or sometimes, I suppose, sometimes they are shut down. But at least they swear in the eternal firmament. At least they were up there at all. At least they had all that way to fall.
I believe Hunter Rose's qualities are the stuff from which all men of power are carved. There is always a quality that accompanies overt capability. That is the fact of achievement. At first, it is by requirement, but eventually there is desire, which all too soon becomes need. Grendel's existence was unfortunate. He He burned with a potency that rarely emerges in society. Sadly, we often miss the beginning sparks of such infernos, and so must suffer their consumption rather than profit by their well-nurtured power and warmth. Regrettably, Grendel has always been. He is the demon of society's mediocrity.